Are you ready?
The PAMP attack.
In 2005, Aaron Brown was fired from CNN, not because his ratings were poor, but because he was one of the few journalists alive during that time who actually had enough courage to criticize the Iraq invasion. Brown was replaced with lockstep talking heads who were too lightweight and too intimidated to analyze the facts and conclude the obvious, which is news media had become a part of the war propaganda machine that promoted the war frenzy rather than objective discussion. They didn't ask questions. Instead, they delivered prepackaged, soma-drenched, dullard brain lies on behalf of the Pentagon. But 2 years before that, Brown was booted from CNN. Phil Donahue was removed from MSNBC for being critical of the Iraq war and for questioning the narrative coming out of the Bush White House. And just a few weeks ago, Ed Schultz was removed from MSNBC because he dared to talk about issues like the TPP and Keystone XL pipeline and to question the political motives of President Obama and Hillary Clinton. There are not enough people to fire in the corporate-controlled media to allow it to begin looking relevant again. But that doesn't appear to concern management because advertisers are still willing to pump millions into programming that nobody is watching. If you have more than 40 tattoos, for example, no doubt you don't miss Nancy Grace when it comes on. If you want to simply snooze with a little inconsequential background noise, well, Wolf Blitzer's Situation Room is the place you want to go. I've had the opportunity to ask many of the most important personalities in mainstream media whether or not they believe news journalism is in trouble. Here's what I found. From Helen Thomas and Dan Rather to Phil Donahue and Bill Moyers, all are in agreement that quality news journalism in mainstream media is either dead or dying. It's gasping for its last breath. Helen Thomas, who worked as a journalist covering 9 U.S. presidents, said that news journalism is no longer capable of being a watchdog for democracy. According to Bill Moyers, news journalism has been dumbed down to the point where there is no longer an adversarial relationship between government, corporations, and the press. Instead, the Washington Press Corps today wants to be pals with the parts of government that spin political policy. The result of that relationship is the media pounding the drum for war where no war is needed. On top of that, they slept through an economic meltdown while the government spin machine drove America towards an economic class divide that's not been seen since 1929. It's a news media that quit asking tough questions of an administration that trades inside access for childlike obedience. As we watch the Fourth Estate die, an infotainment creature that has replaced real investigative news journalism is flourishing. Newsrooms in every part of the mainstream media have been underfunded and replaced with talking heads who simply are not bold, informed, or entertaining. They're little more than infotainment gibberish specialists who fill our minds with facts about Kim Kardashian's boyfriends or the Duck Dynasty boys telling us that God hates liberals. In 1980, 50 separate entities owned the major parts of American media. The media was the marketplace of bold ideas, liberal, neocon, moderate, and all shades in between. Today, only 5 conglomerates own all parts of mainstream media. Once you understand that, it's not difficult to understand corporate rules of operation because there is only one rule: always increase profits. In mainstream media today, both print and electronic real news, journalists, and bold commentators run the risk of extinction. Gathering real news with higher-paid, experienced journalists is just too expensive. The new mega corporations that own the news media would gladly trade a dozen critical thinkers like Ed Morrow or William F. Buckley for one underachieving, inexpensive infotainment fool who never spends a minute boldly reporting or doing commentary about stories that analyze our American democracy's new illness. There's a paradox here. The flying monkeys of the right, the ones who are released anytime one of their own steals, accepts a bribe, or breaks the law in a public bathroom, continually parrot the notion that we have a liberal media. But mainstream media is clearly neither liberal nor conservative. It's simply another corporate entity that struggles desperately to increase profits by transforming itself into an infotainment creep show. There's never been a better time for citizens journalism to flourish. Today, every outraged, conscientious, and mortified American has the capability to create and deliver better journalism on the internet. Just go to Talking Points Memo, Alternet, Raw Story, or the Brad Blog, or Ring of Fire Radio, and understand that those products were launched on a shoestring budget, and today they help change the political narrative almost every day. Or tune in to Tom Hartman, or the Young Turks, or Amy Goodman, and understand that in every instance, those products were created with minimal money and a monstrous faith in the idea that the media could be better. Go pick up half a dozen independent newspapers around your community and recognize that those same kinds of small independents helped launch independence in America. Again, most of those independents started on a shoestring budget, and almost always they were driven by sheer commitment of people just like you who understood that they could think and write and analyze and comment on the state of world affairs at least as well as Wolf Blitzer or Nancy Grace or Chuck Todd. Citizens journalism is our last best hope, and I doubt there is anyone listening to this broadcast who's not capable of being part of that.